Data visualizations in platform analytics use graphics to show table, indicator, and other data. They replace reports and performance analytics widgets in the core UI, combining and extending their functions. Visualizations show your data in its current state. They can also answer questions about trends and forecasts of future performance by visualizing data from indicators, also known as KPIs. Visualizations can be created by any user with access to data. Owners of data visualizations can access and share them with other users. This can be done with or without editing rights and with or without the right to share further. To create a data visualization, navigate to the Data Visualizations library. The default view displays all data visualizations in a list view. You can filter the list by name or description. The bookmarked filter helps you easily find data visualizations you've selected from the library. The certified filter shows visualizations that an administrator has certified. You also have filter options for visualizations that you own and that have been shared with you. You can refresh the list and copy the data visualizations library URL to the clipboard. To create a visualization, click New to open the Visualization Designer. The Visualization Designer provides all the tools to create and configure the visualization you want, from its data source to visualization type to grouping and colors. Let's create visualizations to show active tasks as well as their assignment status. Click Add Data Source. Let's select the source, in this case, the task table. Then we'll define the conditions we want to apply by setting the condition as active is true. Our visualization type defaults to single score. There are many different types of visualizations for us to choose from, like bars, pies, and donuts, multidimensional charts, and others. Let's choose a vertical bar. There are other options available for visualizations, such as header and border, data sources and metrics, as well as display settings, and options for chart interaction. Add a group by to refine the visualization. Let's group by state. Additional color options are available, such as fixed element, single color, or color palette. Finally, let's give this visualization a name and description. And then save. And then name the visualization as it will appear in the library. Once created, we can add to an existing dashboard, or in our case, a new dashboard with this visualization as its first element. To edit a visualization directly in a dashboard, click on the visualization and use the dashboard's inline editor to make changes. Many of the options are the same in the dashboard's inline editor as in the visualization designer. You can adjust the visualization type and data source on the dashboard itself, but be aware that this may result in information loss. For more extensive edits, use the visualization designer, which provides a wider range of options, including advanced chart interactions. You can duplicate visualizations to create variations and share, export, or schedule them for distribution to other users. Select Share to choose users and groups to share the visualization with. Choose whether to add as viewer or editor. Or select Copy Link to share the URL. Users with access to data visualizations can share it with specific users and groups. Users with the admin and viz admin roles can share visualizations with specific roles as well. Visualizations can be exported to other formats for reporting or presentations. And exports can be scheduled to update stakeholders regularly. Bookmark important ones for quick access. Create, organize, and filter visualized data from your instance, and then share it with stakeholders by export and scheduled delivery. To learn more, see our product documentation or knowledge base, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.